Rig is a commercial species that's managed under the quota management system. It's a small shark that grows to about a metre and a half long, and it's better known to most people as the fish and chips sometimes, and also sold in fish shops as lemon fish. The females come in and give birth to their young in estuaries and harbours throughout the country, and the young remain in those estuaries for up to 6 months. So we believe that estuaries are important nursery areas for these animals. But although we know a little bit about that in some estuaries, for most of the country we have no information. So the Ministry of Fisheries contracted us to conduct a nationwide survey of estuaries to try and firstly locate rig nurseries around the country, and secondly to try and identify the highest priority areas. First one, Christy, do you want to measure it?
There are concerns that if their estuaries become polluted and if we destroy their nursery grounds, then it might be a major threat to them. So when we have large rains and on areas where there's deforestation or even in urban sites with a lot of construction, any place where the soil is exposed, then we get a lot of runoff, and that sediment enters the rivers, and then those rivers lead to the estuaries. And a lot of times, sometimes it gets flushed out to the ocean, but a lot of times it gets dumped into the estuaries. And so over time, we're seeing a lot of the estuaries are becoming more muddy when they used to be sandy. And so I'd like to look at how that's affecting rig and if it's affecting their feeding, because they mainly feed on crustaceans that are in or on the sediment. So if the sediment changes, that could be a major impact.
So here we have the tanks, which we've set up with six little rig sharks. We've set them up here so that we can do a feeding study and figure out how they feed, hopefully how it relates to the estuaries. So here we have a tank with sand in the bottom, and here's a tank with mud in the bottom. We're just trying to answer a few questions at a time, and hopefully more studies will come and they can answer more questions.
Once we've identified the important nurseries, we're going to begin looking at the human impacts on those estuarine areas. The major regions we'll be talking about will be Kaipara Harbour, Manukau Harbour, Waitemata Harbour, so all the big harbours in the Auckland region, Raglan Harbour and Porirua Harbour near Wellington. So we'll be gathering data on the impacts from sedimentation, dredging, marine development, pollution and so on, that are already available from mostly regional council work in those areas. We'll then be trying to find out if any of those impacts look like they might have some effect on the juvenile rig. And ultimately, we'll be reporting back both through the Ministry of Fisheries and regional councils to try and identify measures that we can take to reduce those impacts. The idea is to boost the amount of juvenile rig that come from those nurseries and recruit out to the adult populations that are being fished commercially.